Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Sew with Zinni. My name is Ezinne and I make tutorials based on fashion and DIY. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for sticking around. And if this is your first time seeing this channel, please do well to watch the video to the end and do not forget to comment, like, subscribe and share. So this is a beautiful ball dress with cloud effect that I made for my beautiful daughter as she turned one. So on today's tutorial, we are going to learn how to make this dress, and if this is what you think you'll be interested in, please do well to watch this video to the end. Now, without wasting much time, let us move straight to the tutorial. So now we have to start first by drafting the bodice part of this dress. So please do not forget, this dress is for a 1 year old girl and these are the measurements we'll be using. Already I've drawn a line at the beginning of the pattern paper, so my measurements are going to be followed afterwards. So these are my daughter's measurements and these are the measurements I'll be using for this tutorial: my shoulder, my neck width, my neck depth, chest, half length and waist measurements. So I'll have to start first by marking out my half length, which is 8 inches. I'll mark this all through and then I'll rule a line across. So now the next thing is to mark her shoulder. Her shoulder is 8.5 divided by 2, which is going to give 4.25. Then I'll mark it out and then I'll come down directly under it and I'll mark 5 inches, which is the armhole measurement. Then I'll go ahead and rule it a straight line down. So now her neck width is 2 and I'll go ahead and mark that also. Now after that, from my shoulder, I'll go ahead and come down by half an inch, mark it and then draw a slanted line from there to my neck width. So now the next thing will be to mark her chest measurement. Her chest measurement is 5 inches, so I'll go ahead and box it. Now after boxing it, I'll go ahead and add my 1 inch sewing allowance. Please, this is very important. Now the next thing will be to determine the midpoint of our armhole. The midpoint of our armhole will be 2.25. We'll go ahead and mark this and then we'll go in by 0.25. After marking it, we'll make a slanted line slanted line back to the shoulder. After doing that, we'll then go ahead and make a curve down to our chest area. Now the next thing will be to mark our waist. For our waist, we'll go ahead and bring down our chest measurement down to our half length line. That will be our waist. Sorry, I wrote 19.5 on my measurement chart, but I'm going to be using 20 inches because I do not want it to be tight on her. So now the next thing is to determine the neck depth of this dress. The neck depth that we'll be using is 2.5 inches. So we'll go ahead and mark it and then connect it back to the neck width. So it will be important for us to know that this dress has an alternate design, so we are going to be creating that design now. So with our pattern master, we'll go ahead and make a curve from our neck width down to our chest area. This now becomes our new armhole design. Okay, so now the next thing we are going to be doing is to draft the back pattern. So for our back pattern, we'll go ahead and rule a line. After ruling a line, we'll go ahead and start marking out our zip allowance. So the zipper allowance we'll be using is 1.5 inches. We'll go ahead and mark this all the way to the top. So after marking our zipper allowance, we'll go ahead and repeat the same process we did for the front. So the next thing we'll be doing now is to mark our neck width, which is 2 inches. After that, we'll go ahead and mark out our shoulder, which is 4.25 as well. So after marking our shoulder, we'll come down by 5 inches and then mark that as well and then connect the line up to the shoulder. And then we'll go ahead and box it. Now the next thing will be to determine our chest area, which is 5 inches. After marking that, we'll go ahead and mark out our 1 inch sewing allowance and we'll do the same thing for the waist and then we'll connect it all together. After that, on our shoulder line, we'll come down by half an inch and then we'll connect it back to the neck width on the slanted line. After we are done with that, the next thing will be to determine the midpoint of our armhole and then we'll go in by 0.25, connect it down to up to the shoulder and then make a curve down to our chest line, just like we did for the front pattern. Now, the next will be to determine our neck depth as well, which is 2.5 inch, and connect it back to our shoulder slant. Now, after that, we'll go ahead and then draw out our alter neck design, just like we did for the front as well. Now, after we are done with this, we'll go ahead and label our zipper area. So now this is the type of design that our back will be having, and for us to achieve that design, on our neck area we'll go ahead and mark out 1.5 inches and then we'll come down on our zipper area by 4 inches and then connect this line, because it is going to be like a curve. So we'll mark out 4 inches and connect it back with our pattern master back to the top, to the neck area. Okay, now from that area, just as you see me doing, we are going to be making a horizontal line on the zipper allowance. That is going to be our new zip allowance. Next will be to just label our front area and then our back area. Okay, this is our front pattern and then this is our back pattern. So the next thing we'll be doing is to just cut it out. So now I'm done cutting it out, and this is what the front and the back bodice pattern looks like. Now that is the zipper for the back. Now the upper side of the back is going to have a net or a mesh fabric. This is just to create the design that I want. Okay, so it is going to have a net fabric, so I'm going to cut out the side that is going to be the net. So yes, this is it. I'll go ahead and draw a straight line. Then after I'm done with that, I'll label where the net is supposed to be and then go ahead and just cut it out. So yes, this is the fabric I'll be using for the front and the back bodies, also for the skirt part of the ball gown. So in total, I'm going to be making use of 1 yard of fabric for the purpose of this dress. So yes, I've placed my pattern on my fabric. In case you're wondering what type of fabric this is a bridal satin or a doll face, as some of you may know. So I added 1 extra inch at the bottom of the fabric. This is going to serve as my sewing allowance for the bodice and the ball dress of the skirt. So I've gone ahead to pin them properly. Now the next thing will be to just cut them out. Also remember that we are going to be cutting 2 pieces of this each. That is 2 pieces for the front bodies and then 2 pieces for the back bodies, making it 4 pieces in total. So one is going to be serving as the lining and then one is going to be serving as the main outer fabric. So here I have my net, and it is called the bridal net in some market. This is because the texture is a little bit tougher than the regular soft net. Okay, I'll also advise you use this kind of net so that your ball dress will get to stand and give a good effect. So I'm making use of 12 yards of this net. This is because I want it full and I won't be making use of any hard net to make it stand. Okay, also I'll be doing a cloud effect design at the edge of the ball gown. So now, first of all, I'll have to cut or divide the net by 4 yards into 3 parts, so that when I'm done cutting it, I'll have 3 pieces of 4 yards that have been cut. Okay, so that is it. So please, if you don't understand this part, kindly replay it so that you get to understand it well. So this is 1 piece of my 4 yards. So please remember that I told you that we'll be cutting 3 pieces each for this 4 yards. So this is the first piece of my 4 yards. So I've already cut it and folded it. Now if you multiply these 4 yards each by the 3 times that we have cut it, you see that it will still give you the 12 yards. So we are right by our calculation. Okay, so we'll start first by ruling a line at the top of our fabric so that we can start taking our measurements from there. So now afterwards is to measure out the desired length of the ball skirt. Okay, so how you get the measurement is to measure from the baby's waist down to where you want the length to stop. Okay, down to the desired length, whether it's on the knee or above the knee, or can even reach the baby's feet. This is just if you want, but for my daughter I'll be using 11 inches. This is from the waist to the desired length that I want the ball dress to stop.
So yes, after marking this first layer, I'll go ahead and mark the second layer. So this is how I'm going to mark it to the end of this net fabric, okay? So the net fabric usually comes by 60 inches. So I'll keep on marking it down to the end, just as you see me doing in the video. So yes, I'm done marking it out here, just as you can see, and the next is to start cutting it out layer by layer. So yes, we are done cutting it out now, and here we have 5 layers of this net, okay? We'll go ahead and get the other 4 yards to start cutting out. So yes, this is the second piece of the 4 yards. Remember I told you that we have 3 pieces, so this is the second piece, and we are going to be doing exactly the same thing that we did for the first piece of the 4 yards, okay? We'll mark out 11 inches, rule a line, and after we are done, we'll cut it out. So we are also done cutting the second piece, and we have 5 layers as well. So now for the first piece we have 5 layers, the second piece we have 5 layers, so all together we have 10 layers. For the 2 4 yards that we have cut, we have 10 layers. Now we are going to be setting this aside and move over to the third and the last piece of 4 yards that we have cut, okay? So now this is the third and the last piece of the 4 yards that we have cut, and for this we are not going to be doing exactly the same thing we did for the first and the second piece, okay? Because we are going to be using this for the cloud effect. So the length that we are going to be cutting for this is going to be shorter than that of the first and the second piece. Here I'll start first by drawing my margin, and afterwards I'll go ahead and start marking out my desired length. So I'll be using 5 inches for this cloud effect, so I'll go ahead and mark these 5 inches all through down to the end of the net fabric. So here I'm marking it out and cutting it out as well. This is just because I want to save time and make it faster, nothing serious. So you can as well just mark it out and before you start cutting it out, or you mark it out and cut it any which way you feel is fine. That is totally okay. So yes, I'll do this to the end of the fabric. So yes, I'm done cutting it out, and altogether I have 10 pieces, 10 layers of this that I cut out, okay? So yes, I did 5 inches and altogether I have 10 layers of it. So now the next is to show you how to start making the cloud effect. So now the next is to take out 2 layers of this that I've already cut out. So now I'm going to be opening up the first layer, and I'll also open up the second layer, and then the next thing I'll do is to place these 2 layers together by each side, okay? I'm going to place them side by side together. Now after making sure that they are placed side by side together, just as you see me doing in the video, I'll go ahead with my sewing machine and run a loose stitch on the middle, okay? It has to be at the middle, okay? So after running the stitch, I'll go ahead and then start gathering it together. Now when I'm done gathering, I'll come back and show you guys what it looks like. Remember, we are placing 2 layers by the side, okay? We are not just using 1 layer, we are using 2, so that it gives you the effect that we want. And before I come back to show you the result of the cloud effect, I'm going to show you how to gather the ball skirt area, okay? Now for this, remember that what we have here is 10 layers altogether. So we are going to bring out 2 layers of this as well. Place them side by side to each other and we are going to start gathering. Okay, this is the same thing with the cloud effect, just that for this we are going to start doing the gathers from the beginning of the fabric, from the top part of the fabric. Okay, also remember that we are placing 2 layers together. Okay, we are not just using 1 layer of net, we are using 2 layers. This is just so that it could give it the effect, the kind of effect that we want. I'll go ahead off camera and gather the layers and then I'll come back and show you what it looks like. So remember, I'm gathering them 2 layers each. Okay, so this is it. I'm done gathering it and this is how it looks like. Okay, so here I've gathered it and I've adjusted it to the waist that I'm working with. So over here we have 4 layers. Now remember that we joined two pieces together to give us this 4 layers, so altogether we have 8 different pieces. So we joined it 2 by 2 together, so yes, we have 4 pieces. Please, if this is not clear, you can go back and replay it.
So now I've gathered all my layers together, remaining 1 layer, this particular layer, which is going to serve as the outer part where the cloud effect is going to stay. Okay, so now before I start gathering it, I'm going to be placing my crinoline effect under, and after I'm done placing my crinoline, I'll go ahead and place my cloud effect that I've already made on it. So yes, this is the loose stitch that I already made for the drawing of the gather. So I've already made it and I'll go ahead and turn it and show you how to attach the crinoline on this net fabric. So this is how to place your crinoline even on normal dresses. Now for this, you have to hold the 2 of the net fabric together. After holding it together, you place your crinoline on top, and now with about 2.5 inches you have to make a stitch, run a long stitch across to the end of wherever you want it to stop. Okay, so after I'm done making the stitch, I'll just come back and show you what it looks like. So this is it, as you can see, and I'm done making the stitch. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys the next line of action. So I'll turn my crinoline around. Okay, I'll turn it over to the back, just as you see me doing in the video. After turning it, I'll go ahead and place it on the wrong side and then I'll start making a stitch along the edge of the crinoline. Okay, so just as you see me doing in the video, that is where I'm going to be making my stitch. Now I'm going to do this off camera and I'll come back and show you what it looks like. So now after stitching the crinoline, this is what I have. Okay, so please, whenever you're working with a crinoline, make sure that your needle is as sharp, so don't let it get bent in whatsoever way because it's going to affect it. Now the next is for us to start placing our cloud effect. Okay, so remember the cloud effect that I said we are going to gather. This is it, we have gathered it all. So we are going to start placing it on the crinoline side by side and piece by piece, just as you see me doing in the video. And after I'm done placing it, I'll come back and show you guys what it looks like. Okay, so yes, I am done stitching the cloud effect to the crinoline and this is how it looks. Okay, so this is how beautiful it is looking already, and I've also gone ahead to gather my 2, so everything is just coming out nicely and well done. So I placed the cloud effect on the crinoline and then I sewed it in the middle. Okay, so yes, this is how it looks like. So now the next thing is to bring all the gathered 2 that we have done. Okay, the gathered layers that we have done, the 4 of them. So we'll bring it together and we are going to place all of them together. Now we'll hold all of them down together and then we'll stitch it. Okay, so we have 4 that we have gathered, so we are going to be placing it all together. We have 4 that we have gathered plus the outer layer which has the cloud effect. So we'll go ahead and place these all together at the edge or at the beginning of the ball skirt. Okay, and then we'll sew it down, we'll stitch it down to hold it together. The
whole 5 layers. So after I've stitched down these 5 layers together, I'll come back and show you what it looks like. So this is what it looks like. This is the final look because I have stitched them down together. I placed all of them side by side. So here we have 5 layers all together. I held them down and then I ran a straight stitch across. Okay, so now it has been joined together and it has already appeared beautiful as well. So now that we are done with the down part of this dress, the next thing we'll be going to is the bodice. Okay, we are going to go ahead and continue with the bodice part of the dress. So now this is the front bodice, and for this front part we are going to be making a pleated design with our tool. Okay, so we are going to just make a pleated design with about 1/2 inch on each of the pleats. So we'll just go ahead and do that all through. So yes, we are done with gathering the tool. Okay, we are done with pleating it, and this is what we have. I held it down with pins so that it doesn't go out of place. So I'm going to trim out the excess, and when I'm done trimming out the excess, I'll place my iron on it and then hold it firmly before I'll go to the sewing machine and then sew all the edges so that it can be held properly in place. Okay, so this is it. I've ironed it to hold it in place, and I've also sewn the edges, and this is what we have. So look at it and see how neatly everything has been placed, and see where I sewed it together at the edges, and as you can see, everything is coming out beautifully well. So this is my inner or the lining. Okay, so I'm going to be joining only the armhole area. Okay, so I'm going to just join them together just for the armhole part. Also, I use tape for the front part. This is just to give it a firm finish. Okay, this is optional as it's just for a 1-year-old, but I wanted to use it so that it can give it a firm finish. So yes, I have joined my 2 armholes together, the inner and the outer part, and this is what it looks like. Okay, so now we move over to the back area. So this is the back, and this is our net. We have already cut out our net, and we are going to join all these pieces together so that you can see. So yes, this is how the back is going to be. Though I've not yet joined it, but I'm going to be showing you guys how I'll be joining it. So this is how I'll be joining the lining and the main fabric with the net. Okay, so you just have to observe closely so that you understand. So I've placed the lining with the right sides facing each other. So I'll go ahead and hold them down with pins, then afterwards I'll use my sewing machine and run a stitch across. So yes, I'm done holding them down with pins, and this is how it's going to be after I've sewn it. So I'll go ahead and do the same thing to the other side and come back and show you guys how it looks like. So yes, I've sewn it up together, and this is what it looks like. So I went ahead to sew it with about 1/2 inch. So yes, this is what it looks like. I did it to the 2 sides of the back. The next thing we'll be doing is to join the front and the back bodies together. Also remember the side that your zipper is going to stay and face so that you do not misplace it with the armhole area. Okay, that is very important. Now place the back bodies and the front bodies together. When you hold them together, then the next thing you do is to open it up. Okay, hold the linings together and then the main fabric together as well, just as you see me doing in the video. open it up and then you hold it down with pins and then you run a stitch across. Just remove the number of inches that you used as your allowance. If it's 1 inch, if it's 1.5 inch, you remove it and then you run your stitch across. So yes, I'm done joining the front and the back bodies together, and this is what it looks like. Okay, so this is our bodies. Also, because this is a child's dress and you need the dress to be very comfortable on the child, everywhere needs to be concealed properly so that it doesn't itch the child. Okay, so that is why you must use inseam finishing for this. So everywhere has been concealed. So now the next thing will be to join these bodies to the down part, that is the ball skirt of the dress. Okay, so now this is the ball skirt and I'm going to be joining it with the bodies. So first of all, I'll have to open up the bodies, and this is what it looks like on the inside. So I'll be joining only the front part of the bodies, that is the outer layer, the right side. So that is what I'll be joining to these ball skirts, and the lining area is going to be joined with the lining part of the skirt, the half circle skirt that I talked about. Just as you see me doing in the video, I'm going to be joining the main side of these bodies to the ball skirt that I've already joined together. Okay, so I'm going to be joining this together just as you see me doing. I'll first and hold it down with pins so that it helps me join it. So now when I'm done holding it down with pins, I'll take it to the sewing machine and stitch all the places that I've held down with the pins. So yes, this is how it's going to look like when I take it to the sewing machine to sew. So this is how the outcome will look like. Although I've not yet stitched it, it's still being held down with pins. Also remember that I only held the front part, so the lining is yet to be attached, and I'm going to be using a lining, a skirt lining for that. Okay, so I've already cut my half circle and I've also used bias to finish the edge of the skirt. Okay, so this is how it looks. I cut a half circle skirt and I've used bias to finish off the edges. So I've also ironed it and this is how it looks like. So I'm going to be attaching it to the lining of the bodice. Just as you see me doing in the video, that is how I'm going to be attaching it. So I'm placing the right sides of the two lining together, the bodies and the skirt part, and then I'll hold it down with pins. After I'm done holding it down with pins, I'll take it to my sewing machine and then I'll run a stitch across, and then I'll come back and show you guys what it looks like. So yes, I'm done stitching it and this is how it looks like. Okay, as you can see, it appeared very neatly. And if you're trying to sew this and it's difficult for you to sew on your sewing machine, you can use your needle and thread. Okay, so look at the inner, the lining. I've also sewn it, and if you should notice, the lining is shorter than the main fabric. Okay, it's not supposed to be the same length. Now when cutting the length of the lining, you can just remove like 2 inches from the main length of your dress. Okay, so that it makes the lining shorter. Now this is the inseam finishing, and as you can see, everything has been concealed properly so that it doesn't bring discomfort to the child. So now we are almost rounding off with our dress, and the next thing we'll be attaching is our zipper. Okay, so we are going to hold it closely together and then remove our zipper allowance, attach the zipper, and I'll come back and show you guys how it looks like after I have already attached it. So yes, I've attached the zipper and this is how it looks like. So as you can see, everything has already started to come out well and nice, and I'm going to open the zipper for you guys to see how the inside looks as well. So yes, this is how the zipper area looks like when opened, and you can't even tell where it was attached from, because everything looks very neat on the inside and both on the outside. Okay, so this is what it looks like. And also, if attaching an invisible zipper with an inseam finish is the type of video that you guys would like to see, please do let me know in the comment section so that I can consider making a video on that. Okay, now the only thing remaining for this is the band that we are going to be attaching to the neckline of this baby ball dress. Okay, so I've already cut out the band and I've also gone ahead to iron this band. Okay, I've folded the parts that I'm going to stitch and I've ironed it inside. Okay, so this is just a band that you can cut. This is just a band, so we'll go ahead and attach this band on the neckline for both the front and the back. Okay, I'll go ahead and do this off camera, and when I'm done attaching it, I'll come back and show you guys the final look of the dress. Because we are done with this dress, there is nothing else that will be added aside the bow tie, so I'm going to just do this, and then when I return, I'll show you the full look of the dress. Ta-da! So this is the full look of our dress. Okay, this is the transformation. We have added the band, we've also gone ahead to add some appliques, some flower petals. We just attached this with our gum and it is sitting really pretty. We dressed it up on our baby mannequin and this is how everything looks like. Okay, this dress is giving everything a shoot, and we also went ahead to attach some lovely stones to the net part of the back. Okay, also for our band, we've used a hook and bar closure, okay, to hold the band together to her neck, okay, so that it laps on the neck. So we've attached this, we attached that with needle and thread. So our mannequin is a little bit bigger than our dress, so it couldn't zip up. Also, we've attached our pressing button for where our bow tie is going to be. Okay, so we attached it on the two sides of the bag. So this is where we are going to clip our bow tie, and I'm going to show you that. So yes, this is our bow tie, and then when we zip up the dress, we just clip it to the dress and it just stays there. Okay, so this is how the bow tie looks like. So yes, this is the final look of the dress. I'm also going to quickly show you my daughter wearing this dress for her birthday shoots and how it looks like on her. So yes, this is my daughter wearing the dress and this is how beautiful it looked on her. So if you enjoyed watching this video, please do well to give me a thumbs up, comment, share, and please do not forget to subscribe. Also, put on your notification bells below in order to get notified whenever I post subsequent videos. Okay, if you've watched to this point, thank you so much. God bless you. Bye, and see you in my next video.